With the massive success of the MCU over the years, fans everywhere were highly anticipating what the 22 films were leading up to, finally coming to an end with Infinity War, the Jim Starlin Thanos comic brought to life on the big screen. The film takes place directly after Thor Ragnarok, and we see Thanos and his Black Order destroy what's left of the Asgardians using the Power Stone. He obtains a Tesseract, and the opening credits roll. Throughout the film, Thanos goes on a quest for the rest of the Infinity Stones, obtaining them all pretty easily. The Reality Stone from the Collector, the Soul Stone from Vormir after killing Gamora, and finally, after a heated battle with Doctor Strange, Spider-Man, Stark, and the Guardians, Thanos acquires the Time Stone. Doctor Strange tells Stark it was part of the 14,000,000-to-1 chance they had of ultimately defeating him. Captain America, who is now the Nomad, and others gathered in Wakanda to protect Vision's Mind Stone, the last stone needed in the gauntlet. After a huge climactic showdown, despite the efforts of Cap, Thor, and Scarlet Witch, Thanos succeeds in his goal and snaps away half the universe. The film opens with Tony and Nebula adrift in space, almost a month after the snap. Tony records his last words to Pepper and plans on drifting away, when suddenly Captain Marvel appears and rescues them. Back at Avengers HQ, the team is reunited and come up with a plan to track Thanos to get the stones back so they can undo the fuckery, which takes them to the Garden, a planet Thanos plans to retire on. After learning that Thanos destroyed the Infinity Stones, Thor finally goes for the head, and then that's that. Fast forward 5 years later, the team is disbanded. Cap leads his support group for those who can't move on. Banner merges himself with the Hulk. Thor becomes the Big Lebowski, and Stark started a family with Pepper, seeming to be the only one who has truly moved on. That being said, though, Black Widow stayed behind at HQ, still trying to find ways to undo the snap. All hope to bring back the fallen population of the world seems lost, until Scott Lang gets freed from the Quantum Realm, thanks to, yep, a rat. Thanks, rat. He goes to the Avengers with a crazy idea.
Time travel!
The team gets back together and they assemble the Quantum Tunnel, letting them execute their...
Time heist?
Yeah, time heist. You heard it right. Cap, Tony, and Scott go back to the Battle of New York from the first movie and attempt to collect the Time, Space, and Mind Stones. Only that plan falls to shit when Loki intercepts the Tesseract. Rocket and Thor go back to Asgard during the Elf Invasion and get the Reality Stone. And Meow Meow. Mjolnir? Rhodey and Nebula obtain the Power Stone from Morag right before Star-Lord can get to it in the first Guardians movie. Before they can leave, though, Nebula malfunctions and accidentally sends her knowledge to the Nebula of that time, who still worked under Thanos. Hawkeye and Black Widow travel to Vormir to get the Soul Stone from the Red Skull. The Black Widow ultimately sacrifices herself, feeling it was her destiny. Back to the botched New York mission, Cap and Tony travel to the 1970s to Camp Lehigh, the Army camp-turned-shield base that trained Steve Rogers to become Captain America. There, Tony gets the Tesseract and inadvertently runs into his father, Howard, giving him the closure that he truly needed. Cap also had a run-in with his love, Peggy Carter, the one he never got that dance with. After obtaining the stones, the team assembled the Nano, or Stark Gauntlet, and proceed to bring back the Fallen. But not before past Nebula poses as the current one and sends Thanos into present time. Thanos and his army destroy the Avengers facility and lay waste to the Avengers. Even Cap wielding Thor's hammer isn't enough. It's that moment when audiences everywhere shit their pants with three simple words. Portals everywhere open, flooding the battlefield with every character ever to grace the MCU. There were the original Avengers, newer Avengers, Revengers, Guardians, Ravengers, Wakandans, sorcerers, and everyone in between. It was fucking nuts. Once you get your composure, though, Cap catches Mjolnir and says,
"Avengers!" Assemble.
And then it's on. The Avengers start
kicking ass.
And it's truly amazing. The gauntlet gets passed around, avoiding being taken by the Mad Titan, finally ending with a standoff between Stark and Thanos. The rematch. Thanos overpowers Stark and snaps his fingers, then realizing that Stark has the stones. Iron Man snaps his fingers and erases Thanos and his army for good, but killing himself in the process. After a brief but sad funeral, Cap goes back to return the stones to their rightful places in time. Let me just stop right there. So I'm sure everybody wonders the same thing. How the hell did Cap return the stones? Maybe it's not supposed to be thought of that deeply, but guess what, Marvel? I'm thinking it. The only stone that he couldn't really return was the Soul Stone. Even if he did, Black Widow couldn't come back. She gone. Also, wouldn't he encounter the Red Skull? How awkward would that be? Hey man, don't need this stone anymore. Thanks. Oh, and Hail Hydra. So Cap returns the stones, but never comes back to the present. Then Falcon and Bucky see Old Man Cap on a bench, who stayed behind to live a full life with Peggy Carter. He gives Falcon his shield, passing on the mantle of Captain America. You know, I could waste a lot more time diving into the time paradox fuckery of this movie, but I won't.
Time travel!
So with Cap and Tony gone, what's next? Well, what I do know is that Disney is planning a bunch of spin-off shows for Disney Plus. Hawkeye, where Barton teaches his protege how to be Hawkeye. I don't really think anybody's going to watch that one. Loki, following the not-dead Loki who stole the Tesseract. Again, not a big Loki fan. But I am interested in Falcon and the Winter Soldier, where Sam takes on the mantle of Captain America. I know most of you wanted this, but then ended up getting this. And that's just the way it is. I mean, that's fine with me. I read that Baron Zemo is making a comeback as well. And then we have WandaVision. I'm not really sure what to think about this one, considering that Vision is dead, but I do know it takes place around the 1950s and ties closely into Doctor Strange 2. Aside from that, we should be getting a Black Panther 2, a Guardians 3, which has Thor teaming up with the Guardians, and a possible Adam Warlock appearance. Captain Marvel's due for a sequel. And a Namor movie? I mean, nobody wants to see that shit. We already got a better one. And I don't even want to mention... Yeah. All in all, Endgame was amazing. It really got the job done, closing the door of all the movies leading up to it. Alright guys, well that's it for this one. Love you 3000. See ya.